Hello students, let us start with the second exercise of sequence and series. Before starting the second exercise, let us understand about arithmetic progression. What is the meaning of arithmetic? If the difference between first and second term, second and third, third and fourth, all the terms in continuation, if the difference between these terms is same, then it is arithmetic progression. If I subtract first term from second, second minus third minus second, and fourth minus third, then the difference obtained should be equal. This type of series is known as arithmetic progression. Now, in this series, first term, that is A1, is A, and second term is A plus D, and third term is A plus 2D, and fourth term is A plus 3D. Now, the difference between all the continuation terms, all the terms which are in continuation, is D. It means we can write the nth term as a plus n minus 1 into d, because if the term is fourth, 3 d's are there. If the term is 3, 2 d's are there. It means if there is nth term and we have to write nth term basically, then we have to write n minus 1 into d, its nth term. With the help of this formula, we can find out any term of the series. It's also known as L, or last term of the series. If we have to find out sum of the series, then we can use this formula, n over 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d, where a is first term and d is common difference, n is number of terms whose sum is to be calculated. And the second formula is A plus L. If we know the last term and the first term and number of items, then we can apply this formula. All the terms I have already explained, what is the meaning of A, D, N, L and SN. The second important formula is arithmetic mean. Suppose I write three terms which are in AP, small a, capital A and B. If these terms are in AP and A is arithmetic mean between A and B, then I can write A minus A is equal to B minus A. It means 2A is equal to A plus B, and A can be written as, that is arithmetic mean, can be written as first term plus third term divided by 2, a plus b divided by 2. Now let us start with the exercise. In the first question, we have to find the sum of odd integers from 1 to 2001. The series is given to you. 1, 3, 5, these are the odd numbers from 1 to 2001. If I write odd numbers between 1 and 2001, it means we have to eliminate 1 and 2001. If we write the odd integers between, it's from 1 to 2001, it means we have to start from 1 and ending with 2001. Now in this series, A1 is given to you. First term, that is A is equal to 1, D, 3 minus 1 is 2, and last term is 2001. Then apply the formula, L is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. By inserting the value, we can calculate the value of N, that is 1001. Now apply the formula of SN, it's N by 2 into A plus L. First term is 1 and 2001, 1001 divided by 2. Because number of terms is 1001, simply cancel these terms. 1001 divided multiplied by 1001, it's 100201. It's the answer. Let us check the second question. Now, look at this statement, lying between. It means 100 and 1000 is excluded, which are multiple of 5. It means you have to find out the sum of all natural numbers between 100 and 1000. What is the meaning of between now? You have to exclude 100 and 1000. You have to write the numbers between 100 and 1000 which are divisible by 5. First number is 105, then 110 up to so on, 995. It means I can write the value of A. What is the meaning of A? A means first term and D means 110 minus 105. It's 5, the difference. L is the last term. In the first step, you have to calculate the value of N, then insert that value in the second formula, that is Sn. L is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. L is known to you. A is also known to you. And value of D is also known to you. 105 when subtracted from the left hand side, it's 890. N minus 1 into 5, then divided by 5, you will get the value of N. Then in second formula, N by 2 into A plus L. The value of N is 179 divided by 2. First term is 105 and the last term is 995. When you add these values, it's 1100. 179 divided by 2 into 1100. 179 multiply 550, it's 98450. Simply you multiply the things. Question number 3. In an AP, the first term is 2. It means A is equal to 2. The sum of first 5 terms is 1/4 of the next 5 terms. Sum of first 5 terms is equal to 1 over 4 next 5 terms. Let the common difference is D. And you have to show 20th term is minus 112. Okay. What about the first value? First value is A. And second can be written as A plus D, then A plus 2D, A plus 3D, A plus 4D. Now add all the items. It's 5A plus 10D on the left hand side. Now on the right hand side, 1 over 4, 6th term, then 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th term. Add these terms. It's 5A plus 35D. Divide both sides by 5. You can find A plus 2D on the left hand side, 1 over 4. A plus 7D on the right hand side. Multiply 4 on the left hand side. It's 4A plus 8D. A plus 7D. Then subtracting A from left hand side. 4A minus A. It's 3A. 7D minus 8D. It's minus D. It means D can be written as minus 3A. And A is given to you. The value in the statement. That's 2. Minus 6 is there. It means we are now with two items A and D. Value of A is 2 and value of D is minus 6. We can easily calculate now A20 or any other term. A20 is A plus 19D. Value of A is 2 plus 19 into minus 6. It's 114. 2 minus 114. It's minus 112. Question number 4. The series is given to you. Also sum is given to you. And you have to find the number of items or number of terms required for the sum minus 25. First term is minus 6. And what about D? Second term minus first term. Because minus 6 is there, it means you have to write plus 6, then take LCM, you can obtain the value of D, that is 1 over 2. And what's required, Sn is minus 25. Now insert the value in the formula Sn, n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. What's the value of a? It's minus 6. And value of d is 1 over 2. Then take LCM. It's minus 24 plus n minus 1 divided by 2. Now multiply 2 on the left hand side. In first step, this 2 is multiplied by minus 25. It's minus 50. Then again, it is minus 100. And inside the bracket, it's n minus 25. Now multiply on the right hand side, n square minus 25n. Simply, it's quadratic equation. You can factorize this. Equation is n square minus 25n plus 100. Clearly, you can migrate or you can factorize this. Minus 20n minus 5n, n into n minus 20, 5 into n minus 20. You can find the value of n as 20 and 5. Two values are there. Question number 5. In an AP, if pth term is 1 over q, what is the meaning of pth term? It's a plus p minus 1 into d. It's 1 over q. And qth term is 1 over p. It means a plus q minus 1 into d. It's 1 over p. And you have to find spq, 1 over 2 pq plus 1. You have to prove this. Now you are provided with two equations. You can easily calculate the value of a and d by equating the coefficients. Already the coefficients are same, that is a. Then subtract, a and a cancel with each other, and by subtracting this, p minus 1 minus q plus 1, the answer is p minus q. And 1 over q minus 1 over p, take LCM, it's p minus q divided by qp. And then p minus q cancel with each other, it means d can be written as 1 divided by qp. Now, insert this value of d in this equation, that is equation number 1, so that we can find out the value of a. Put in number 1, it's a plus p minus 1 into d basically. Now, the value of d is 1 over qp. Now, multiply this value inside the bracket. The first term is 1 over q. The second term is 1 over qp. On the right hand side, it's 1 over q. Now shift this negative term on the right hand side, it's 1 over qp. Now what about Sn? The formula of Sn is n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. But in place of n, now the required item is pq. In the second step, insert the value of a and d, which we find above before this summation. 2 into 1 over qp, pq minus 1, 1 over qp. Then take LCM. We can write 2 plus pq minus 1 divided by qp. Qp and pq cancel with each other. And in numerator, pq plus 1, 2 minus 1, 1 divided by is there. It is the required answer in the statement. Question number 6. If the sum of certain numbers, number of terms in the AP 25, 22, 19 is 116, find the last term. We have to find an. Value of a is 25. And what about d? You can calculate this value. Second term minus first term, it's minus 3. And Sn is given to you, 116. And you have to calculate the value of L. Now what about Sn? The formula for Sn is n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. The value of Sn is 116, n by 2, value of a is 25, and value of d is minus 3. It's n minus 1 into minus 3. Open the bracket, 53 minus 3 and multiplied by 5. Then shift the terms. One quadratic equation is there. It's difficult to factorize. That's why I solved this problem. using the formula of minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. This value is a, this value is b, and this value is c. We have already completed this formula in class 10, quadratic equations. 53, square of 53 is 2809. 4 multiply 3 multiply 32, it's 2784. The value is 25. The square root of this value is 5. Then you can obtain 58 over 6 and 48 over 6. Two values are there. But these are number of items. 29 of 3 is not possible. 8 is possible. It means answer is 8. Now you can calculate the value of L, that is last term. A plus n minus 1 into d, value of a is 25, then 8 minus 1 into minus 3, 7 into minus 3, it is 25 minus 21, the answer is 4. Now question number 7, you have to find out the sum of n terms of an AP, whose kth term is given to you, that is 5k plus 1. If I know the term, I can design the series. Insert value of k is equal to 1, answer is 6, then 11, 16, 21, it means the series is 6, 11, 16, 21, up to so on. It means first term is 6 and common difference is 5. Now simply calculate the value of Sn. The formula for Sn is n by 2. 2a plus n minus 1 into d, it's 12 because a is equal to 6, n minus 1 into 5, then 12 plus 5n minus 5, 5n plus 7, now simply multiply this, 5n square plus 7n divided by 2, because n is not known to us, we have to calculate Sn only. Question number 8. This question is the important question as far as your final examination is concerned. If the sum of n terms of an AP is Pn plus Qn square, where P and Q are constant, find the common difference. Because Sn is given to you, if I insert n is equal to 1, I can find out P plus Q. If I insert n is equal to 2, means it's 2p plus 4q. Similarly onwards. S1 is equal to A1 because it's the first term. What about S2? Basically, it is the sum of first and second term. A1 is p plus q, that is A. S2 minus S1. If I subtract this, it means this value is A2. A1 plus A2 minus A1. This value is A2. Now, basically, what about this value? The second term is 2p or S2 is 2p plus 4q. And what about S1? This value is p plus q. Now, subtract this value. You can find p plus 3q. It means it is the second term. Basically, you have to subtract S2 minus S1 so that you can find A2. Now, the series is p plus q and p plus 3q onward. It means what about common difference? P plus 3q minus p minus q. P and p cancel with each other and the answer is 2q. This question is also an important question. The sum of n terms of two APs, similar to this question, you have already completed in class 10th. I think you find this question in your final examination also in class 10th, CBSE. The sum of n terms of two APs similar to this one, maybe this question or similar to this one in your final examination, are in the ratio 5n plus 4 and 9n plus 6. Find the ratio of 18th term. Suppose two series are there. Number of terms are same, but first term and common difference is different. then you can write small a, small d, capital A, capital D like this, but you can write n as same value. 5n plus 4 over 9n plus 6. N by 2 cancel with each other. Now divide numerator and denominator by 2 on left hand side. You can obtain a plus n minus 1 over 2 into d and capital A plus n minus 1 over 2 into capital D. Right hand side remain as it is. Now this point is important. If we have to find the ratio of 18th term, it means this value should be equal to 17 because A plus 17D is equal to 18th term. It means N can be find out equal to 35. Now insert this value of N on the right hand side. You can find out 5 into 35 plus 4, 9 into 35 plus 6. The answer is 175 plus 4, 315 plus 6. It's 179 divided by 321. It is the final answer. Question number 10. If the sum of first p terms of an AP is equal to sum of first q terms. Now what about SP and SQ? Write the formula. It's n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 over 2. On the both side, you can write the formula by inserting p and q. And you have to find the sum of first p plus q terms. Now you can cancel 2 from both sides. Then multiply 2ap plus p square minus p into d. Similarly on right hand side. Now shift the values from right hand side to the left hand side. First value is without d. You can write separately 2ap, 2aq. And similarly, you can collect the second items from which d can be taken as common p square minus p minus q square plus q into d. And taking 2a common from first two terms and factorize p square minus q square, it can be written as p minus q into p plus q. Then take p minus q common, inside it's 2a plus p plus q minus 1 into d. P minus q cannot be equal to 0 because p is not equal to q. It means internal term is equal to 0. Now basically this internal term lies inside Sn. It means the answer is 0. Hope you understand the concept of sum of AP. In the next video, we will discuss about geometric progression.